गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर नंबर 3, फाइल मैनेजमेंट एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ डेटा। सो फर्स्टली लेट मी टेल यू व्हाट इज फाइल मैनेजमेंट। फाइल मैनेजमेंट इज द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ फाइल्स एंड फोल्डर्स इन अवर कंप्यूटर। अवर कंप्यूटर आल्सो keep track of all the files and folders which are stored in its memory. Whenever we perform various operations on files and folders, they all come under the file management. For example, if you are creating files and folder, if you are renaming files and folder, if you are deleting files and folder, or if you are copying files and folder from one location to another location, or you are moving files and folders from one location to another location, and other memory related operations such as compressing the files to save the memory, cleaning the disks to increase the computer memory and increase its performance. So all these operations, they come under file management. So here we have the meaning of file management. So file management help to organize and keep track of your files and folder in the computer. You can save your works and files and folder in very easy way. So this is, you already know that whatever work you do in the computer, for example typing work is there, you are making documents, spreadsheets and presentations like that, and all your work gets saved in files. And further, you can arrange all the files in folders. Next we have the meaning of files and folder. So file is a document in the computer. So your data, it is stored in the form of a file. So different types of files can be there, for example drawing, text, picture, sound, videos, audios. So different files can be there, and every file is having a unique name. Two files at the same place, they cannot have the same name, but two files at different places, they can have the same name. And all the files, they are represented by an icon. So icon is the small picture or a thumbnail picture which is assigned to a file according to its type, that is called icon. Next we have folder. So folder is also used to organize the files. We can keep our files at one common place, and that common place is called folder. Folder also has a unique name. It contains files and subfolders. Subfolder means a folder within a folder. So you can double click the folder to open it, and even you can double click any file to open that file and to see its content. Next we have understanding disks and drive. So here we have the two things, disks and drives. Disks means your hard disk. For example, in your computer, you store data inside a permanent memory that is called hard disk. So it is non-removable, means you cannot remove the hard disk frequently from the CPU, because the hard disk is fixed inside the computer cabinet. Then the second type of memory is called disks, and they are called removable media. Means the media which can be removed from the CPU. For example, pen drive, you can remove it. CDs and DVDs, you can also remove these medias. Then you can also store your files and folders inside the disks and drive. So disks are the removable media, and drives are the fixed media, for example hard disk. It is having different drives like C drive and D drive and E drive. So the partitions which your computer shows of the hard disk to store data, it is called drives, whereas disks are the removable media. Now hard disk can be divided into logical drives. Suppose your computer is having 1 terabyte of hard disk, and further that 1 terabyte can be divided into logical drives, and every drive is having a drive letter and a colon sign, for example A and colon. So this is the drive letter, and colon sign is the sign that is used with the drives. So A drive, we will call it A drive, and this is the B drive. They both are used for floppy disks, but nowadays floppy disks are not used in computer. So hence A drive and B drive is also not used in computer. Next we have the C drive. So C drive is the first drive of your hard disk. Similarly, you may have D drive, E drive, F drive, G drive. So all are the drives, and for the majority of cases the drive D, it is used for the CDs and DVDs. So whenever you will put a CD inside the computer or DVD, you can open that CD or DVD and you can see the contents by opening the D drive. Next we have path. Path means the location where the file or a folder is saved inside the computer memory. So for example, you have this. Firstly, you have the C drive, backslash Windows is the folder, backslash calculator.exe. So this is the file, and this is the complete path or complete address of the file where this file is stored in the memory. That is called path. Here you have path of folder and files. So similarly, a folder or a file, they are also having a path where such files or folders are saved. Next we have how you can view the files and folders. In order to view the files and folders, in Windows 7 you have the 4 main folders which are created by default. And the folders are, first you have the documents folder, then you have the pictures folder, then you have the music folder, and lastly you have the videos folders. So Windows 7 will arrange all the files under these folders. Means if you are creating any office related files like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, they will be stored in the documents. If you are working with the pictures, they will get stored automatically under the pictures folder, music files here, and video files here. So if you want to see any files, you can double click on the computer icon. It will show you the My Computer box or window, and here on this side you will get the libraries in this task pane. Under the libraries you will get these folders for document, music, pictures and videos. So you can click on the any folder and the contents of this folder will be shown to you. And whenever you download anything from the internet, you can check the downloads folder. So here you have this under the favorites downloads. It will show you all the files which you downloaded from the internet. Are the hard disk drives. You can click any drive to see its content. Here is the folder. You can double click the folder to see its files. And Whenever you will open a folder and subfolder, then here the path of that file will be shown. For example, these files are stored under the libraries, documents and important files. So this is the path of these files. Here you have transferring data from one drive or one device to another. If you want to copy or move your data, you can transfer it very easily in Windows 7. Copy means the files or the folders, they will remain on its original place as well as they will appear in the new location. Move means the files or folders, they will be removed from its original location and they will only appear in the new location. That is called move. Here you have the steps for transferring data. Firstly, you need to open the disk drive and select the files or folders that you want to copy. After selecting all the files and folder, you have here organize option. Click on this. Here you have two options, one is for cut and one is for copy. If you want to move the data from here to somewhere else, then click on the cut option. But if you want to duplicate copy, if you want to generate of this data, you can click on the copy button. After clicking the copy button, just open the new location where you want to paste. Again, click on the organize and choose the paste option. Then your data or the files will come here. Here you have the shortcut keys for copy, cut and paste. That is Control C, Control X and Control V. You can also use these for copying data or moving data from one location to another. Next, you have transferring data from one device to another. Suppose in your computer you want to copy data from the hard disk to pen drive. So that is called transferring data from one device to another. Or if you want to copy data from one pen drive to another pen drive, so that you can do here. So similarly, you have to open the drive or the select the files that you want to copy or paste. Click on the edit option. Here you have two button, one is copy to folder and second is move to folder. If you want to copy, then click copy to folder. If you want to move these files, then click on the move to folder. Then it will open you this copy items box. From here you can select the pen drive or DVD drive or whatever you want to copy in the, then select this file, then click the copy button. So it will copy the data from this location to Kingston, that is the removable media drive. Here copy button is coming because you have selected the copy to folder. If you will select move to folder, then move button will be there. Next, you have transferring data to CD or DVD. So simply you can insert the blank or recordable CD and DVD in the computer. Autoplay box will appear, then that you can simply close. Next, what you have to do, again select the files that you want to burn in the CD, and here selecting the files. Okay, firstly you have selected all these files and then you have the burn button here. Click on this button. So this is the burn button. Burn means burning the data into the CD or DVD. Whenever you store data in the CD or DVD, that is called burn. Clicking on the burn button will show this burn a disk option. Here you can enter the title for the CD. That will show you next time when you will open the CD. And here you have two options, like a USB flash drive, how you can burn, like a USB flash drive or with a CD and DVD player. If you have to see the contents in a CD or DVD player, then you have to choose this option. But if you want to use this CD or DVD with the computers, then you can choose this option like USB flash drive and click on the next button. It will ask you to format the CD, then click the yes button. After that, it will take some time to burn the data in the CD. And here, same thing is coming, the speed is also coming. So preparing the disk, so disk title is file backup, or you can take as per your choice. Here burning speed will come like 10x, 20x, 50x. So if you will burn the CD at lower speed, it will ensure the reliability of the CD and data. But if you will burn the CD at higher speed, then the reliability of data or the CD is very less. So simply choose whatever is selected by default and click the next button. So it will start the copying or burning process, and after some time it will show you the message, you have successfully burned your files to the CD, and then you can click the finish button. Here you have the types of CD, that is CDR and DVD-R. They are the recordable CDs and DVDs. Compact disc and digital video disc. R means recordable. So these CDs are recordable, and you can record these CDs just once. Only one time you can record it. Once it is recorded, after that the files or folder whatever are recorded on this CD, they cannot be deleted and they cannot be restored. So whatever is data stored on this CD or DVD, that is recordable CD or DVD, it is permanent after that. Next we have working with the multiple files. If you are working with the multiple files, same task you want to accomplish on several files, that is called working with multiple files. For that you need to select the files and you can perform the same operation on all the files. Next we have the switch between windows. So here, as you know, Windows 7 is a multitasking operating system. It means you can open the several tasks at the same time, or you can do work in the several windows at the same time. For that you need to open the multiple window. For example, here MS Word or WordPad is also open for typing, and here Paint is also open for doing some painting work. So this is the bar that is called taskbar in Windows 7. It will show you the icons for the opened applications or the windows. Simply you can click on the icon of the application that you want to open. So this window is the active window because this is the selected and I am currently working in this window. That's why it is called active window. And the second one is the passive window. If you will click on this window or that window's icons, that will become active window. For example, here WordPad is in front of all the windows, and here Paint is in front of the all windows. So this is the way to switch between windows. And you also have a shortcut keys for switching between window using the keyboard. For that you need to press the Alt key and Tab key. Firstly press the Alt key and hold that key, and then you can press Tab key to switch between windows. Next you have the snap option. So this is very important option in Windows 7, or this is the feature of snap that is used to resize and arrange the open window by simply dragging their borders to the edges of a screen. Suppose here one window is open and you can drag the window from its border and you can adjust with the edges of your screen. So this window will automatically arrange on the dragged side. If you will drag one window to this side, this window will automatically adjust on the left side. So here you have the edge, depending on your choice. You can arrange something on the top or bottom, left or right. So according to this, window will expand vertically, it will fill the screen, and even you can position the windows side by side. So one window is here on this side and one window is here on that side. And for that, suppose you want to see some data in both the files, you want to compare the data of this with this, then you can arrange the window side by side. Here you have how to use this snap option. Firstly, you have to drag. Drag means using the mouse left button, you can click that button and you can drag the mouse to the other position. If you will drag the window to the left side, it will arrange on the left side. If you will drag the window to the right side of the screen, it will be arranged on the right side. Next, we have the jump list. So jump list is a new feature in Windows 7, and that feature you can use by right clicking on the app icon in the taskbar. So here, whenever you will hold the left button or whenever you will right click here on any of the icon, it will show you a pop-up menu, and in that pop-up menu it will show you the frequently used options. For example, here you right clicking on the Internet Explorer, so it is showing you the frequently visited web pages. If you will right click on the File Manager, it will show you the recently files and folders. If you will right click on the Music Player, it will show you the recently opened music files. And these files which are recently opened, recent items, they are called destinations in the jump list. From here you can open the files which you are opening recently easily with the help of a jump list. Here is the thumbnail preview. So thumbnail preview means without opening the whole window, you want to preview what is going on in that window. So this option is called thumbnail preview. For example, in the taskbar, if you will click on the Internet Explorer or any icon that is present here in the taskbar, if you will click on that icon, that window will appear on the screen. But if you will move the cursor here on the icon, and actually you are not clicking that icon, you are just placing the mouse cursor here, it will show you a preview. For example, mouse cursor is on the Internet Explorer, it will show you a small thumbnail here. So that is showing the screen of actual window. So this is called thumbnail preview. Next, you have the pinning option. So pin means you want to add shortcut of the programs which you use frequently. So every time you can pin the options from here, start button. So start menu is open, and select the program here and drag the program on the taskbar. It will ask you to pin to taskbar, and you can drop the programs or shortcuts here or files here. So next time you can directly open that file from the taskbar easily. So that is called pinning. Here you have the next option, that is called arrow shake option. So the arrow shake option is used for shaking the windows. So as the name is showing, arrow shake, so it is relating to the shaking of window. But the thing is, why we are shaking the window? Here you have, you can select any window. Suppose you have opened several windows on the screen. You can select any window from the title bar. So for example, this is the active window, or this is the window you want here. You can select this window, and by holding the left button of the mouse, you can shake it on the screen. Whole window you can shake. What will be the result of this? All other windows, they will be minimized, and the window that is shook, it will remain active on the screen. So if you want to restore, again you can shake this window. All the windows which are minimized, they will come back on the screen. So this option is called arrow shake. Suppose here several windows are open. I want only calculator here. The rest I all want to minimize. What I will do? I will click on the, I will hold the calculator from the title bar. Then I will shake this window on other windows. What will happen? Other windows will be minimized and only calculator will be present on the screen. Next you have the arrow peak option. Arrow peak means when several windows are open on the screen or on the desktop, you are unable to see the desktop because the whole area is filled by these windows. But if you want to see the desktop contents, you have to minimize all. Only then the desktop will appear. But suppose without minimizing all the windows, you want to see the desktop. For example, here all the open windows, they are becoming transparent here. As you can see, this window is also transparent. This window is also becoming transparent. Calculator is also becoming transparent. And here the desktop area is visible to you. This you can do from the right side button is present here on the taskbar. This is called show desktop button. So what you have to click, you have to click and hold this button. What will happen? It will make all the windows transparent. Whenever you will release this button, automatically the windows will become normal. So this is called arrow peak option or arrow peak feature. Next you have searching files and folders. In your computer there can be thousands of files and folders, and you can search the files and folders that you want in the computer. So this is the great option in Windows 7 for searching the documents. And here you have the method for searching. For searching, you can click on the start button. Start menu will appear. In the menu you have this search box. Inside the search box you can type the name of file or folder that you want to
After that you can put a star. So it will search all the files and folders which are starting with BOO. Rest they can have any characters, but they must file format is the layout of file, and file format is the name of file and its extension. Because depending on the type, every type of file has a different extension. So here I will give you example. Suppose you are saving a file in MS Word and your file name is hello, then MS Word will save the file with the name like this, hello hello, then a dot will be used, and then this is the docs file. So hello, this is the period sign which is used in all the files for the different file formats. The name which is given before the dot sign or before the period sign, it is the file name. This is called file name. And the part which is after that period sign, it is called extension. So docs is the extension of this file, and this part is the file name, and this part is the extension. Docs means document file. So the files which are created in MS Word, they are called docs file. And the extension is having 3 or 4 characters. All the extensions, they are having 3 or 4 characters. Here one example is given to you, that word processor like MS Word, it will display the file with .doc or .docx file formats. .doc means document, .docx means extended document. Actually .doc was used earlier in the older version of MS Word. So before MS Word 2007, .doc was used. But after the MS Word 2007 and onward, .docx is used in the new version of MS Word. So prior to MS Word 2007, .doc was used, and after that, .docx is used. So here some file formats are given: Word document .doc or .docx, web pages .html or .html, images .gif file, .jpg, .tiff, .png. All these are images. PowerPoint files .pptx, Adobe Acrobat files .pdf, executable program .exe, multimedia files .mp3 and .mp4, Access database file .mbd. It is not mbd, it is .mdb. mdb for the database file, and .eccdb, access database. So all these are the different file extensions. This is the icon for Word file, this is the icon for HTML5 file, this is the icon for JPG file, this is the MS PowerPoint file icon, this is the PDF file icon, this is the executable file icon, this is the MP3 file icon, this is the Access database file icon. So all the files, they are having different icons, they are having different extension according to the file type. So that's all in this chapter, and give proper reading to this chapter to understand all the concepts. And if anything is confusing you, you can contact me. Thanks for watching. Take care.